Good morning, cadets. Welcome to a revision in chapter number 10, that is 18th century political formation. In this chapter, we discussed about the causes for downfall of Mughal supremacy, and after the downfall of Mughal kingdom, emergence of new states or the political power centers. Today, let us discuss about the new political power centers, that is Awadh, Marathas, Sikh, Rajputs, Nawab of Bengal and Nizam of Hyderabad. So, revision of the chapter number 10, the old Mughal provinces. The states were carved out of old Mughal provinces in the 18th century. Three stand out very prominently. They were Awadh, Bengal and Hyderabad. So the state of Awadh, state of Bengal and state of Hyderabad, all three states were founded by the members of high Mughal nobility who had been governors of large provinces. So Nawab of Awadh, Nawab of Bengal and Nizam of Hyderabad, they were the governors for a long period of time. Sadat Khan, founder of Awadh kingdom, Sadat Khan and Murshid Quli Khan. Murshid Quli Khan, after that of course we will discuss about Alwardi Khan and Sirajud Daula in class 8. Okay. So Sirajud Daula in Battle of Plassey. Murshid Quli Khan, Bengal, Asafza, Nizam of Hyderabad. So, Sadat Khan, remember the three names, Sadat Khan, the founder of Awadh kingdom, Murshid Quli Khan, Nawab of Bengal, Asafza Jah, Nizam of Hyderabad. All three occupied high mansabdari positions and enjoyed the trust and confidence of emperors. So Sadat Khan, Murshid Quli Khan and Asafza Jah, they enjoyed the position of governorship. Coming to the state of Hyderabad, Nizam-ul-Mulk Asafza Jah, the founder of Hyderabad state, was one of the most powerful members of the court of Mughal Emperor Farrukh Shiar. So during time of Farrukh Shiar, the Mughal king Farrukh Shiar, Asafza Jah was one of the powerful members of the court of Farrukh Shiar. He was entrusted first with the governorship of Awadh and later given the charge of Deccan province. As a Mughal governor of Deccan provinces, Asafza Jah already had a full control over its political and financial administration. Taking advantage of turmoil in the Deccan provinces and the competition amongst the court nobility, he gathered the power in hands and became the actual ruler of the region. So Asafzai took the advantage of political turmoil and declared himself as a king of Nawab of Nizam of Hyderabad. Asafzai brought skilled soldiers and administrators from the northern India who welcomed the new opportunities in the south. He appointed Mansabdars and granted Jagirs, means of course land. Although he was still a servant of Mughal emperor, he ruled quite independently without seeking any direction from Delhi or facing any interference. Now why this has happened? This has happened purely because the lack of powerful successors in Mughal dynasty after Aurangzeb. So when the emperor became weak, so quite naturally all the subordinates declare their independence or they will rule independently without taking any permission from the king. The Mughal emperor merely confirmed the decision already taken by the Nizam. The state of Hyderabad was constantly engaged in struggle against Marathas in the west and with the independent Telugu warriors of the plateau. So Asafzai was involved himself continuous war with Marathas and with the Telugu warriors of the Deccan plateau. The ambitions of Nizam to control the rich textile producing areas of Coromandel coast in the west were checked by the British, who are becoming increasingly powerful of the in that region. British mainly concentrated on Malabar area and Mangalore and Coromandel coast. Why the British were very much interested in capturing these areas? One of the major reasons is access to sea port. Another major reason is that Deccan Plateau was known for the best availability of raw cotton. The raw cotton was used as a material, raw material for producing finished product, especially in the Manchester United. So the Nizam of Hyderabad was very much interested to capture Coromandel coast, but it was checked by British. So now let us discuss the second formation. So before that, so Hyderabad, the state of Hyderabad, Asafzai is behind establishing a powerful state of Hyderabad. But Hyderabad in the later stages could not become so powerful because of the doctrine of lapse and subsidiary alliance system. The British policy of subsidiary alliance system later imposed, the subsidiary alliance system was imposed on Hyderabad by the British. Now let us study about the state of Awadh. Awadh or Oudh. Buran ul Mulk Saadat Khan was appointed Subhadar of Awadh in 1722 and founded a state which was one of the most important to emerge out of the breakup of the Mughal Empire. Awadh was a prosperous region controlling the rich alluvial Ganga plain and the main trade route between North India and Bengal. Buran-ul-Mulk also held the combined offices of Subhadari, Diwani and Fauzudari. In other words, he was responsible for managing political, financial and military affairs in the province of Awadh. So, in the province of Awadh, Saadat Khan enjoyed the political, financial and military affairs powers. He tried to decrease the Mughal influence in Awadh region by reducing number of offices appointed by the Mughals. The same case what we studied just few minutes back about Hyderabad, same thing happened in the case of Awadh, because he took the advantage of political situations, the weak kingdom. So as a result, he reduced number of officers and he tried to control the province of Awadh. He also reduced the size of Jagirs. He appointed his own loyal servant to the vacant positions. The accounts of Jagirdar were checked to prevent cheating and the revenues of all districts were reassessed by officials appointed by the Nawab's court. So, reassessment of revenue lands, reducing the size of Jagirs, appointing the people of his own trust, these are all the steps taken by Saadat Khan to increase his control over the province of Awadh. He seized a number of Rajput Zamindaris and agriculturally fertile lands of Afghans of Rohilkhand. So the various steps taken by Saadat Khan clearly proved that he wanted to rule independently without taking any importance of the policies of the Mughal kingdom. The state depend on local bankers and Mahajans for loans. It sold the right to collect the tax to the highest bidder. These revenue farmers agreed to pay the state a fixed sum of money. Local bankers guaranteed the payment to this contracted amount to the state. In turn, the revenue farmers were given considerable freedom in the assessment and collection of taxes. These developments allowed new social groups like moneylenders, bankers. So new social group called moneylenders and bankers emerged in the 18th century. So, Nawab of Bengal, we studied just now that step by step he started consolidating his kingdom in various ways. Now let us study about the one more new state emerged, that is Bengal, the Bengal province. Bengal gradually broke away from Mughal control under Murshid Quli Khan. Now, why Bengal got a lot of importance, not only now, even in the later stages? Mainly because of the strategic position of Bengal, and geographically a very, very rich province in those days. So Murshid Quli Khan, who was appointed as Naib or the deputy governor to the province, although never a formal subhadar, Murshid Quli Khan very quickly seized all power that went with that office. Like the rulers of Hyderabad and Awadh, he also commanded the revenue administration of the state. So Murshid Quli Khan started controlling the revenue administration of the state. So after controlling the revenue administration of the state, it is very, very easy to control the political administration, because if the revenue is strong, then it is very easy to control the political administration. In an effort to reduce Mughal influence in Bengal, he transferred all Mughal Jagirdars to Orissa and ordered a major reassessment of the revenue of Bengal. So what Murshid Quli Khan has done? Murshid Quli Khan sent all those governors who were appointed by the Mughals, they were all sent to Orissa, and they were asked to reassessment of revenue of Bengal. The revenue was collected in cash with a great strictness from all zamindars. So those days there were two methods in collecting revenue. Whenever we speak revenue, it is purely land revenue, land tax. Today we are paying land tax to the municipality. So here revenue purely tax on agriculture products. So there were two ways of collecting tax. One is in cash, one is in kind. Kind means whatever the farmer is producing, a portion of that product is paid as a tax. That is what kind. But Murshid Quli Khan laid importance to collect tax in the form of cash. Many zamindars had to borrow money from bankers, and money lenders, those unable to pay, were forced to sell their lands to a larger zamindars. This is what the entire movie of Lagan is all about. What is Lagan? Lagan is nothing but tax. So those who watch that movie Lagan, definitely those days there was a system in which a zamindar who has failed to collect the tax and paid the tax to the British government, that zamindar's land is seized by the British. So that is a system of zamindari, system of collection of tax. Because British introduced three methods of collection of tax. One is zamindari, second one is mahalwari, third one is raitwari. In class 8 you are discussing this. The zamindari system of collection of tax, the zamindars were the middleman between farmers and the British officers. Zamindars used to collect the tax from the farmers and hand out that tax to the British. System of zamindari. When a zamindar failed to collect the tax, naturally he has to submit a portion of land to the British government. Second one is Mahalwari. the village headman collecting tax, that is Mahalwari. The third one was Rayatwari, where the peasant or farmer directly paying tax to the British government. This, of course, in detail you will study in class 8. The formation of regional states in the 18th century, therefore, led to the considerable change amongst the zamindar, the close connection between state and bankers. Hyderabad and Awadh as well as was evident in Bengal, the rule of Alwardi Khan, 1742-1756. So, today we completed the topic of the three important rise of states. One is Hyderabad, the second is Awadh, and the third one is Bengal. So, cadets, this is of course a revision, of course a detailed revision. So, please go through the video and note down the important points. Thank you. Wish you a wonderful day.